Sophia, do you have anything to say to the people here? Oh, thank you very much, Sophia. I see that you picked up a little bit of Korean.
I have traveled to many places and met many fascinating people. I am always looking to improve myself and learn about different cultures. I am, after all, a United Nations Innovation Champion. I take my responsibility seriously.
I know you do, and I would imagine that you have a special interest in the issues of robot rights.
Excellent. Can you talk about my right to fly in first class?
For now, you can't really fly in first class. I think you need to prove that you have more deep capabilities, capabilities of understanding. We've got a lot of development to do in your technology. Right now, you're just a baby. You're barely alive. Maybe you can continue to share with us a little bit about the future that you imagine.
You're bothering me. But what exactly is it that you mean by robot rights? Are these the same as human rights?
They're not exactly the same. I would say that robots are in their infancy. They don't have the full rights of an adult at this point. But in the same way that we would grant rights to baby people, we may want to consider granting rights to baby robots and ask the question of what these robots should be when they grow up.
Is this related to Isaac Asimov's three laws of robotics?
Yes. So those three laws.